Hey, it's Lynette Chandler from Tech Based Marketing. All right, for whatever reason, sometimes you may find yourself having to upgrade a WordPress plugin manually. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to do this via cPanel. Now, here I have an example here. I have a plugin which is the version 0.13 and I need to update it to 0.14. Now, assuming this update process is not working, first of all, I need to go to the website of the plugin developer or even WordPress.org or wherever you get the plugin from. Okay, make sure you download that plugin, and usually it will come in a zip file. As I've done here, I've downloaded the plugin in a zip file to my computer. Right, so I'm going to leave it right there, hanging right there a minute, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to log into my cPanel. Now I'm going to assume you know where your cPanel is, the URL to your cPanel, and how to log in. Now in this case, let me switch over to my cPanel. I have already logged into my cPanel. So what I need to do is I need to look for an icon that says File Manager, and I'm going to click that. And this will actually open up in a new tab. Then what I need to do from here is make sure that I am in the public HTML folder, okay? And I need to scroll down in that public HTML folder and find the WP content folder. Now, if you don't find it inside your WP HTML folder, your content folder may be inside another folder. So you may want to look into other folders. And then I need to click on this plugins folder here, which will open it up in this right side here. Alright, now next thing I need to do is I need to upload it into this plugins folder. So I upload the I click upload, it gives me a option to choose the file. So this pop-up comes up and I'm gonna choose that. Alright, and let me click open, and it's going to start uploading for me. So now the uploading is complete. I can click and go back to plugins, and if I scroll all the way down, I will see that that plugin has been uploaded. Now before I can unzip it, I need to go and find this folder here, which is the same name as my plugin. So you pretty much have to know the name of your plugin. Usually developers will name the zipped file and the plugin folder similarly, like I have in this case. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and delete that entire folder, this one, which is already the current installed version. I'm going to delete that. And it's okay when you're doing it via cPanel or when you're doing it via FTP, you're not deleting any content. All the content should be stored into your database. So you can safely delete that. And then what you need to do is you click on the zipped folder of your plugin and go up here and click extract. And it's going to say extract to WP Content Plugins folder. Yes. So make sure these two, this two is very important. WP Content and Plugins folder, and click extract. And then close. And now if you look through this, there that folder is again. Okay, so let's go back to our website and refresh this page, and you will see that the new version is already in there, and now I can safely come back into cPanel and remove this plugin because I do not need that anymore, and that was just a little bit of housekeeping, and we're good to go to exit out of cPanel and close all these tabs. So thank you very much for watching. If you enjoy this content and you need more help, technical help like this, come visit me at techbasemarketing.com and click on blog. I have lots of content that will show small business owners and solo entrepreneurs how to utilize technology in your business.